Why is it that super hot pathogens tend not to evolve? Most infectious diseases of humans do not kill all humans all of the time. Why is that? And the answer we would normally give is that a super hot pathogen, one that kills all of its hosts all of the time, is not going to have an evolutionary future. It kills its host, it kills itself, and that's the end of it. Now, if that's true, and it seems like a reasonable proposition, what happens when you bring in a vaccine that is going to keep the host alive? Now that pathogen is not wiped out. If the vaccine is keeping the host alive, but not stopping that pathogen from transmitting on, under those circumstances, then you can imagine these hot strains now persisting in a population. So broadly speaking, we can think about two types of vaccines. There are vaccines which stop the onward transmission of the pathogen from the host. Those include things like smallpox, polio, mumps, rubella, measles, those sorts of childhood diseases. The vaccines we have in humans against those are very, very good, and they stop transmission. But there's another category of vaccines which we call leaky vaccines, which don't prevent that transmission. So they protect the host, but they allow some transmission of that pathogen on to other hosts. Those two types of vaccines, the perfect vaccine that stops transmission and the leaky vaccines, they're going to have very different outcomes. The perfect vaccines stop evolution. They don't allow the transmission, so there's no more evolution. The leaky vaccines, the ones that allow this transmission onto new hosts, they allow evolution of these pathogens because they can evolve from host to host to host and so change. So the leaky vaccines are the ones that we're concerned with. And Marek's disease virus, the vaccines against that are of that sort. They protect the host from death, but they do not stop the host from transmitting a virus onto another chicken. Marek's disease virus, which is a herpes virus of chickens, it's a very big deal in the poultry industry. It used to be a very benign disease, so in the 1950s, it did not cause much harm to chicken. These days, the strains that circulate kill all unvaccinated birds in 10 days. Now, what caused that? One possibility is that it was the vaccinations used in the industry to protect the birds against those diseases. And so we had this idea that evolution like this could happen, that vaccines could drive more pathogenic strains. So we became very interested in testing that, and we've done that experimentally now. And what we find is that indeed, these super hot strains, these ones that kill everything in 10 days, that is not enough for transmission. So if they kill everything in 10 days, that's the end of them. If you keep them alive, the birds alive with vaccines, those strains now can transmit because their hosts don't die. And we found precisely what we predicted. I think one of the important things to get across here is that even though the Marek's disease virus evolved to be much, much nastier than it was, it isn't causing problems for industry these days, precisely because of the vaccinations. So almost every bird, every chicken in the world is vaccinated against Marek's disease, and that controls it. That stops the birds dying. And so if you can vaccinate all of the hosts in a population and that protects them, it doesn't matter if the thing has become more virulent. So what are the implications of this? Well, first off, there's a very real question of whether in the chicken industry, Marek's disease virus itself is going to get even nastier. The second question is, does this have any implications for other diseases in agriculture? And I think it does. There are quite a few things that are vaccinated against where the vaccines are of these leaky types. The one that particularly concerns me is avian influenza. So avian influenza can come in very high pathogenic strains, and those ones are of deep concern to industry all over the world. In the US and in Europe, the birds that get avian influenza are culled. So there's no evolution because everything's dead. But in Southeast Asia, they vaccinate and the vaccines leak. So this sort of evolution could happen with avian influenza. And I think that's a very real concern. So it's natural to ask what this means for human vaccines. And let me first say that there's no question that vaccines are the cheapest, most effective public health interventions we've ever had. The question is about next generation vaccines, things we might develop where the immunity is not likely to be so good and we can imagine leaky vaccines. So for instance, I think it's very, very important that we determine as quickly as we can that the Ebola vaccines that are currently under trial are not leaky, that they prevent onward transmission. We do not want the evolution of diseases that pathogenic going in a direction like we've seen in these chicken viruses. If this sort of virulence evolution takes place, and when it takes place in response to vaccination, it's the unvaccinated that are at the greatest risk. Those are the ones who are going to be exposed to, without protection, to these hottest strains. So again, an argument for getting vaccinated.